Morning boys. So we will continue the chapter number 2, exercise number 2.7. So far in integration I said that some important concept that you have to keep in your mind, how to integrate linear combinations, log method, substitution method, formula method and partial fractions. Clear? So these things you have to use to integrate whatever the function is given. Now in this exercise 2.7, so almost all the problems you have to solve by using the formula. So we will see the question number 1. Simultaneously you have to refer the formula dx over 16x square. So we have relevant formula for this, dx by a square minus x square is equal to. Formulas are there in the page number, you just refer the page number 59. So we have formula, 6 formulas. Apart from these 6 formulas, we have another formula also. So dx by a square minus x square, the formula is 1 by 2a. Log of modulus a plus x by a minus x plus c. So this is the formula for a square minus x square. If it is x square minus a square, just you have to interchange the places and change the sign. That's all. That's the difference. You have to memorize in such a way that a square minus x square is equal to 1 by 2a log modulus of a plus x by a minus x plus c. If it is a square, that is x square minus a square, if these places are interchanged, then you have to interchange these two and change that sign. That's all. Clear? So this is the formula for x square minus a square. So you have to memorize in such a way you find out the difference. Based on the difference, you have to memorize the formulas. Clear? Now, exercise 2.7, question number 1. Compare the formula with the given integrand. Do you have any coefficient other than 1 for x square? We have 16. So, no coefficient other than 1 not allowed. Even if you kept with the 16, we have formula, but you have to memorize so many formulas. To avoid that so many formulas, compare these two, see there is a coefficient of x square is in the formula 1, whereas in the question is 16. So I like to make this is 1, so how do you make, you take 16 outside, though it is not a common factor of the first term. You have to take, doesn't matter about, you get fractional format. So integrand, integration dx over, if I am taking 16 outside, you better you take 1 by 16, here it will become 9 by 16, because 16 will not go exactly 9, so that will be right as a divisor, this you know in the lower class itself. If the number is not exactly divisible by the given number, then you can write the number as a divisor. So minus x square. So the constant may be in fractional format, doesn't matter. Clear? Even you can integrate straight away by keeping 16 as it is with x square, nothing wrong. I did not say that is wrong. Clear? But you have to memorize another one formula. So to avoid to memorize more formulas, if you know a little formula, that will be very easy for you to work out the problems, though it will take only one more steps, that's all. The difference between the direct formula and this one, you will take two steps will be extra, that's all. So for which you have to memorize one more problem. Not only for this, for all the models you have to memorize additional formula for each and every form. If there is 6 formulas are given, but you have to memorize 12. So not necessary. If you want to, no sir, I can memorize all the formulas, you can memorize and work it out. Nothing wrong. Clear? But I am doing with only the formula method. So, 1 by 16 integration dx over, this will, you can rewrite in square format, Why I want to write the square formula? Because formula is given a square. A is constant. So you can write is possible 3 by 4 the whole square minus x square. 3 by 4 the whole square minus x square. Now this is in the form of a square minus x square. Just you see that formula and replace, you will get answer. Is equal to 1 by a is 3 by 4. Log modulus a is 3 by 4 x, no change, 3 by 4 minus x plus c. So you can cancel 1, 3 by 2 fraction will become 2 by 3 log cross multiply, you will get 3 plus 4x by 3 minus 4x plus c. These 4, 4 get cancelled. I skip off one steps. Clear? If both the denominators are same, we can cancel. So 4, 4 get cancelled, get answer 2 by 3 log 3 plus 4x by 3 minus 4x. A square minus x square. If it is x square minus a square format, no changes. Interchange these two, change the sign, that's all. Interchange the place of x and a, and the change the sign between a and x. Plus will become minus, minus will become plus. So this is the method. You can, if you apply direct method also, you get same answer. Question number 3. 1 by 3x square minus 9 dx. 3x square minus 9 dx. So I told you already, no coefficient or along with x square other than 1. Here 3 is there. You take 3 outside, 1 by 3 dx by, if I am taking 3 outside, it will become x square. 3 will go exactly in 9, how many times? 3 times. So 1 by 3 square root of, sorry, integration of dx, x square minus, so you, this is not in square, it is not a perfect square number. But you know, in one whole number we have square root of the same base number. See, 3, 3 is the base, square root of 3 into square root of 3 will become 3. How root base is same, you know the square root is replaced by 1 by 2. When the base are same, you supposed to add half plus of how much? 3 power 1 is nothing but 3. So each and every number has how many square root number? 2 square root. The 3 has a factor, 2 square root factor, 3. 3 has 2 factor with the square root of the same number, square root of 3, square root of 3, 2 factor. So if I say 5, root 5 into root 5. If it is 6, root 6 into root 6. If it is 8, you can write root 10, square root of 8 into square root of 8. So based on this concept, I am rewriting 3 as square root of 3 the whole square, because square and square root get cancelled, that will be not disturb the original integrant. Clear? So I am rewriting this by using this concept, square root of 3 into square root of 3 is nothing but square root of 3 the whole square. So now this is in the form of what? A square minus x square. I told you already, if it is x square minus a square format, then you have to change place, these two places will be interchanged, the sign plus will become minus. So that's all. So this is the formula, same formula, only difference is in the sign, that place got changed. So apply that formula, or you can refer the formula page number 59, and just you have to substitute, you will get answer. Clear? Now we will go to sum number 4. Sum number 4. Integration dx by x square minus x minus 2. Now you check, it is possible to factorize or not. minus 2. 1 into 2, you will get minus, so minus plus is correct. So you can apply partial fractions also. Or you can apply which method I said, completing the square method. Any one method you follow. Here I solve these problems with the help of the formula. But in the examination, either you have to follow formula method or you can follow the partial fraction method. Your wish. Nothing wrong. Clear. So you can do any one of these two methods. So now how to use completing the, how do you apply the completing the square method? What is the basic rule? You divide the coefficient of x by always how much? 2. So x square minus x by 2 minus 2. When you divide this coefficient of x 1 by 2, you will get only 1 by 2. Square that quotient and add and subtract. I am adding the quotient squares and subtracting the square of the quotient. So x square minus x, these two I can use only for your understanding purpose. Clear. So don't write the next stage by 2. So I am directing you that you have to divide the coefficient of x always by 2, for which I mentioned by 2. So don't repeat by 2 again the next step. Plus, because a square, a and b will be always the plus. So a square plus b square, 1 by 2 the whole square. Minus 2 will become minus 1 by 4. So this will become a minus, because we have minus sign, a minus b the whole square. You simplify now, 4 2s are 8. Cross multiply. Just you go for cross multiplication. 4 2s are 8, so minus 9 by 4, minus 9 by 4. So this you can write easily, x minus 1 by 2 the whole square minus 3 by 2 the whole square. Now this is in the form of x square minus a square, x square minus a square format. Now this will become now integration of dx by x minus 1 by 2 the whole square minus 3 by 2 the whole square. This is in the form of x square minus a square. The same formula you can use for this also, x minus a, x plus a. In the place of x, you have to write x minus 1 by 2. Then you can simplify after that. Clear, normal simplifications. So you can apply that formula and simplify, you will get answer. So I will explain only for this problem, because you have fractional format, you may have confusion of how to proceed. So I am writing straight away 1 by 2, a is 3 by 2, there will be no changes. Then log of modulus, what is it? If it is x square minus a square, you have to interchange x minus 1 by 2 minus, because plus will become minus 3 by 2 by x minus 1 by 2. This minus will become plus 3 by 2 plus c. So simplify only inside the bracket, this 2 will go 3 log 2x minus 1 by 2 minus 3 by 2. Here 2x minus 1 plus 3 by 2 by 2. See, both denominators are same. So you can straight away add. You will get answer 1 by 3 log 2x minus 1 minus 3 by 2. 2x minus 1 plus 3 by 2. Am I correct? When the denominators are same, you can add the numerator alone. So these two to get cancelled. So 1 by 3 log, you have to write always plus c, 2x minus 4, 2x plus 2. Even if you take 2 outside and simplify, you will get answer. Clear. Further, you can simplify, you will get answer. So very simple, either you follow partial fraction when the denominators are able to factorize. If it is not able to factorize, so you supposed to follow only completing the square method, then you can apply the relevant formula. Clear? So sum number 5 the same, sum number 8, sum number 5, 6, you please follow either partial fraction method or completing the square method, you will get the answer. Now we'll go to sum number 7. E power x, integration of e power x into dx by, it is given e power 2x minus 9. So you have to remember the previous exercise, that is substitution method, or you can do directly also. Clear? You can do straight away this integration, or you'll go for the substitution method. Better you follow only the substitution method, otherwise you have, I told you already, if you want to directly integrate, you have to memorize other than these formulas, 7 formulas, what is given in the page number 59. So I said very clearly, so you, I can rewrite this by seeing that the numerator, it is e power x, here e power 2x. So I can rewrite the e power 2x like e power x the whole square, 3 square. Is it possible? Not possible. Because power to power you can multiply. You know the basic rule in the lower class, you studied in algebra, that is a power m whole to the power n can be written as a m n. You can multiply the power to power. So based on this concept, I can rewrite e power 2x as e power x the whole square. Clear? Now you consider t is equal to, I told you already what it's supposed to consider inside the bracket, that is e power x, differentiate e power x into dx. So it is there already. The remember, when you differentiate, I told you already for substitute method, the derivative should be there in the remaining part of the question. It is there already. So therefore, this will become dt t square minus 3 square. Now you can apply this in the form of x square minus a square. Another formula, just you have to interchange the place. Refer a square, x square minus a square formula, but in the place of x you have to write t, then you have to replace t by what? E power x, you will get the answer. Or if you know directly the formula also, you can integrate, nothing wrong. Clear? So I am taking this as t, e power x, I am applying the t method because you know very well about the substitution method which you studied in the previous classes. So apply that method, only 2 steps will be extra, these 2 will be extra. The remainings are same only. So after this, x square minus a square formula, in the place of x you have to write t, in the place of you have to write 3, then again you have to replace t by e power x. Final answer should be always in terms of x, because the question is given in terms of what? X. Clear? So after that you can use the formula just opposite of this one, x square minus a square. I told you how to rewrite if it is x square minus a square format. It is x square minus a square formula. So interchange x square minus a square. We have formula in the page number 59. Refer. You replace x by t. After replacing x by t, you have to replace again t by what? E power x. Clear? So complete the remaining part of this problem. Very easy. That's why I am giving more homework. Then question number 8. Integration dx over square root of 9x square minus 7. So you cannot apply that completing the square method because we don't have x term. If there is the x term along with the x square and constant or without constant, you can apply the completing the square method. We'll get the answer and we have relevant formula also. Now this is inside the square root. Previously we did up to sum number 7 without square root. But we have a square root of the denominator. So we have the formula again, dx by, I told you already, no other than 1 should not be allowed along with the x square. The coefficient of x square should be always 1, even if it is some other number, whether it will go exactly in the second term or not, doesn't matter, you take outside. If I am taking outside of the square root, 9 will become 3. Don't write 1 by 9. Your answer is wrong, because 9 is inside the square root. When you take 9 outside of the square root, you suppose take square root. Square root of 9 is how much? 1 by 3. So what are the terms are remainder inside the square root? Minus 7 by 9. Don't write 3 because it is inside the square root. If the 9 will come outside, it becomes 3. If it is inside, 9 will be always remain as it is. Clear? So 1 by 3 x by x square minus, this is not a perfect square, again refer to the previous model, I can rewrite 7 as square root of 7 by 3 because 9 is perfect square number. So now it is in the form of x square minus x square, square root of x square minus a square. We have formula in the page number 59, square root of x square minus a square. You see the formula number 3, square root of x square minus a square. I will write down the formula here. So dx over square root of x square minus x square is equal to log modulus of x plus square root of x square minus a square plus c. So the same way we have plus x square plus a square. So here will become plus. That's all, no change. So only changes will come over here only in the place for plus. If it is plus, there won't be any negative. Clear? So now apply this formula. So in the place of x we have x, but in the place of a what is given? Square root of 7 by 3. Just you have to replace log modulus x, but we have 1 by 3. So it will come 1 by 3 log x plus x square minus a square. So what is x square minus a square? Just you have to write as it is. X square minus 7 by 9. Clear? This is square only, no? So modulus of plus c. That's all. So very simple. If you memorize the formula, then it will be very easy for you to simplify the integrand. Be careful, if it is minus, you have minus sign. If it is plus, there won't be any minus, everything will be plus. Just you have to change the sign alone, depends upon the question. If it is x square plus a square, there will come x square plus a square. That's the difference. Clear? So you have to refer the formulas and proceed. Now sum number 9. Sum number 9. Memorizing the formula is very simple. So you should know the difference in the formula, whether it only get changes in the sign alone. So you never get some major difference between the formulas. Integration 1 by square root of x square plus 6x plus 13. Here you have quadratic form inside the square root. So therefore, we don't know how to simplify it with the term inside the square root in 11th standard. Therefore, you cannot apply the partial fractions method. There is another one method I said. If it is not able to apply the partial fraction method, then what is the next method? Completing the square method. So you take x square plus x, 6x plus 13. I am going to teach only the completing method. I will bring it into standard form. Then refer the formulas and do it. Clear? So x square plus 6x. Now as usual, divide the middle term always by 2. X square. Don't write by 2. When I divide this one, your quotient is 3, add, subtract, then what is there already in that numbers? This will become a plus b the whole square. minus 9 plus 13. Subtract these two, you'll get x plus 3 the whole square minus or plus. Plus how much? 4. So this is x plus 3 the whole square. 4 is a perfect square number, so you can write a. So now it will become square root of dx by x plus 3 the whole square plus 2 square square root. So this is just like the formula x square plus a square. So refer the formula and is replaced in the place of x by x plus 3 in the place of a by 2. So what is the formula for square root of x square plus a square? Just now I said x square plus a square. What is the formula? What log modulus of x plus square root of x square plus a square plus c. This is the formula. Just you have to apply log x plus 3 plus, you can write as it is, x plus 3 the whole square plus 2 square. Close the bracket. You can leave it as it is, or you can expand by using which x plus 3 the whole square is nothing but what? This is. You have to write this is in the place of x plus 3 the whole square by copying this one and simply you will get answer. Either you can leave up to this or you can expand a plus b the whole square form by using a plus b the whole square formula and simplify. You will get answer. What is the answer? You will get same answer. You will get same question. In the place after write this one, just replace the given question. X square plus 6x plus 13. That's all. After write this, simplified this one, you will get this format. So straight away write log x plus 3 plus square root of x square plus 6x plus 13. Clear. So don't think the different one. Either you have to leave it as it is or you can replace this by what? What is given already in the question. That's all. Nothing wrong. Clear. So we will see the remaining problems in the next class. Clear. Thank you boys. You complete. Some problems I gave as homework, some problems I left as it is. So please complete by using the formula. We will see the remaining part in the next class. Thank you, boys.